Hi, Cizrin here, and I wanted to make a quick thoughts video about both Oshabi and Katarina, which, in my opinion, are two boss fights that currently feel a little bit like a punishment, and I just wanted to, like, see how other people feel and get your guys' thoughts as well, especially, like, how different it is between, like, you know, people that play a lot or people that play more casually, and if we're all on the same page or if I'm completely off the mark here. So, Oshabi can now be found in the Grove randomly. However, she will drop some winged scarabs, and she will drop, well, some random stuff and, like, one of her unique items. And I feel like that is very, very unrewarding. The fight is actually fairly hard now, especially she gets the map mods now. And we've seen a lot of people dying to that on hardcore. The problem is, I get so excited right now because Harvest is very powerful. So when I see Harvest, I'm like, oh, yes. And then I open it up and I'm like, oh no, it's Oshabi. Well, I don't even want to do Oshabi. Like, I don't really care about getting a winged metamorph scarab and swapping that around with Harvest for half a year. Like, I don't know. At least for me, it currently feels like a punishment. And I don't think that ever should be the case. Actually, like, I love this league, and this is, like, pretty much, like, one of the few problems I have currently with PoE. But I don't feel like it's particularly good that one of the rare cool things that should be exciting feels like a bad thing. My proposed changes for Oshabi, at the very least, you still get normal harvest fields. But to make it even more exciting, I think they should maybe be either lucky or, like, slightly juiced up harvest fields, or just maybe like 5 or 6. Because so far I've been playing, I think, over 200 hours of Ritual League, and I've only found 2 Oshabis. And both of the time, it felt like a complete waste of my time. And I feel that is, like, a very, very wasted resource. Because it is a cool thing in the game, right? And you should be excited when you find something rare and exciting. At least in my opinion. So I just wanted to, like, know how you guys feel about that. See if we were all on the same page there. Now, there is another fight in the game as well, which is Katarina. And we can show that in-game here. But Katarina is also sort of similar. I feel like Katarina should be an exciting thing to, like, grind up to and get the safe house ready, and then you want to do the Katarina fight. But currently, it's way, way better for most players not to do the Katarina fight. It completely resets your betrayal scheme. Like, it removes all of, like, the green and red things, which is, like, you know, it makes it easier for, like, Vagan can appear when Jorgen's there, even if it's not in the same safe house, because of their relationships. And I think this is a bit of an issue because a lot of people just leave Katarina. Most people are like, oh, you did Katarina? I'm so sorry, dude. Like, oh, you misclicked? Like, it should never be a bad thing. It should never be a punishment for the player to interact with fights like this. And they did already work on improving it because before doing Katarina, you didn't even get the safe houses and what was in there. At least now you get, like, all of the rewards and stuff from everyone. So they have made it better, but I don't feel like it should reset all the relationships and stuff like that. And it also, like, throws out some of the Syndicate members and throws in new ones. So suddenly you have Guff back in your tree. Maybe you don't want Guff there. This one is harder to change than Betrayal. And this one I see, like, maybe there are some people that love the full reset. Maybe there's something I haven't thought of there. But at least for me, like, I think it's very, very punishing right now to do Katarina. I just wanted to make, like, a quick video on both of those 2 fights and see what you guys think. Like, do you guys agree on Oshabi? Do you guys agree on Katarina? Either way, I feel like both of these fights right now are very punishing. And maybe that's only for somebody that plays a lot. Maybe it doesn't matter for people that don't play as much, but I wanted to make a video about it anyway. So, hope you guys are enjoying all the videos. Hope you guys are enjoying Ritual League, my favorite league for a long time. Sub if you like the videos, but more importantly, try to die less than I do.